Okay, so today we will go to the palm oil mill to collect our EFB and PPF samples. So before we go, we need to make sure everything is ready so that when we go there, we are not miss anything. So the most important thing that we need to bring to collect the sample is this. This is plastic bag, the big garbage plastic bag, so that to contain our EFB and PPF. So we can put that once we take our sample, we can put in our bonnet here. But sometimes we take a lot, then this bonnet, even though it's big, it's not enough to what call to hold all our sample. So that's why we bring this two big basin here. The idea is that when we take a lot, we can put this basin on the passenger seat, so that we can put our sample inside this basin, so that our passenger seat will not be dirty lah. And also we have this small basin to in case we want to take something like a pumpkin shell or whatever. And also we bring this glove to not dirty our hand during our collection. And for the audio video, we have this Osmo Pocket 3, and we'll also bring our mic here. And what else? So this is the what we call the rope to tighten this plastic bag. But normally nowadays we use this thing. This is basically the cable tie, but this cable tie is reversible, meaning that it's not like when you tie this thing, the knot it will we'll be able to open it back. So we use this cable, reversible cable tie, a lot lah, so we can just easily tie our sample back there. And here we also have this sellotape and also the marker for labeling, because our thing is black in color. So we can just take this close tape, put on this thing, and then write on that thing, so there are some contrast. Even though we don't label it, we still know which one is PPF, which one is EFB, because the structure is totally different. But if let's say your sample is more or less similar, then you need to have some labeling thing lah, like a marker and also this tape. What else? Okay, so we also have this PPE, personal protective personal equipment. So we have this the boot, the shoes, the what call the safety shoes, and also this what you call this helmet, safety helmet. Normally when you go to any mill, they will provide for you, but in case they don't have extra, then you will be safe lah. Normally when they don't have extra, they will not allow you to go inside. So that's why I bring this together also, so that we can go inside and collect our sample ourselves. What else? Okay, sometimes there will be some meeting when you go for sample collection. That's why I also bring my notebook, a pen, and also we bring also some of our name card lah, in case we meet somebody there. So who knows, that will make will create some collaboration. So we bring our name card for that thing, for that purpose lah. Okay, so what else? Okay, so this is basically the minimum that we bring for our sample collection. And one more thing, inside this what you call this car, because you need to expect also sometimes there are a lot of sample that you need to use this passenger seat, so you need to take it out lah, this thing, the chair from this what you call the passenger seat, so you can put your sample there. And sometimes, okay, so here is extra that we bring. If let's say we know that we have a meeting there, so we will bring some extra audiovisual equipment. So this is a tripod. Okay, sometimes when you use the Osmo Pocket 3, the one that we show there, the tripod is too small. But if let's say you want to do like interview style, interview. I mean, the podcast style interview, is better to have this proper tripod lah. And also, we also bring GoPro. Normally, the reason for this is to take a video of us taking the video. So at least you get this the outsider perspective of our video lah. So it's not necessary, but sometimes it can be useful. And the important thing when you have all this audio visual, be it the GoPro or the Osmo Pocket 3, you need to make sure you have enough battery lah. So here we have the battery for the GoPro, and also we also make sure we charge our power bank so that if anything happen, then we can always charge it on time lah. And here is that just the extra mic. So this is the extra. If let's say we know there are some meeting discussion and we want to take like outsider perspective of our shooting, then we bring this extra lah. But the minimum is always this thing. And lastly, we need to have a bag like this so that we can put everything inside the bag during our collection. Because during our collection, normally we just bring our we need to bring this what we call the garbage bag, and then all this thing is better to put inside the bag lah. Better not to use any like loose bag because you don't know what will happen. So this bag have a what we call the zip. It's much more secure lah when you, especially when you are in the mill, when you are in the what you call quite dangerous side. So you have something that is secure to put everything inside this bag. Okay, so this is the bag, what the equipment, the PPE, and this the extra. Okay, so that's it.
Sometimes you have a tool, so make sure you ready with your touch and go.
Now we are at Palm Oil Factory. So this is shredded EFB, yeah. This is shredded EFB. So there are a lot, you see that there are a lot of the shredded EFB. And yeah, you will take like 3 bags of this because you only have a car. So yeah. Okay. So yeah. So this is the new one. Eh? Okay. So this is boiler. Ini adalah palm food fiber. So ini adalah Encik Zubi. Encik Rizal. So ini Encik Rizal. Ini adalah Encik Rafian. So kami dah ambil palm food fiber here. So this adalah palm fresh fiber, the cyclone, from the cyclone. So you can see this knot. So the cyclone is over there. So that is the cyclone. So ini adalah palm kernel shell. Palm kernel shell ni basically kita tengok dia kering, eh? Dia kering. Palm kernel shell. So we have this. We have the right condition of fresh fruit bunch. So you can see the color is orange in color, so there are a lot of oil. But sometimes when they send the what we call the fruit bunch, sometimes they have also this unripe fresh fruit bunch. Okay, so this is the unripe. The color you can see is quite black, so it's blackish like that. Okay. Okay, ni yang betul-betul muda ha. Oh, dia shell dia pun tak nampak coklat kan?
Ha, dia tu. Dia putih. Dia punya isi dalam ni pun putih.
Okey.
Dia kalau kita makan isi dia ni
rasa kelapa biasa
kan? Kelapa biasa ya.
Memang kelapa lah rasa kelapa.
Kelapa kan.
Oi, yang ni bertarik ni. Nak satu-satu. Nak sebiji.
Tarik nak tu dia pun.
Memang buah muda kan? Oh, dia tak lerai eh? Sangat ni eh. Okey, macam tu lah. Oh, dia putih sangat tu. Ah, ha, keras. Ah, yang tu rasa kelapa eh.
Kelapa.
Ni boleh ni? Ni ke unripe lah ni kan? Maksudnya
muda ke ni?
Dia kalau nak
sebab
yang
sebab dia dah peram, dia dah masuk 2-3 hari. Dia akan, warna dia akan jadi macam ni lah.
Tapi dia tak akan jadi macam warna tu.
Ni sebenarnya dia buah ni, dia nak kemengkal lah, tapi orang potong buah dia.
Okey.
Muda nak kemengkal dia ni.
Okey, dah nak dekat dah kan. Kalau dia tunggu dalam 2-3 hari okeylah. Macam tu. Okey, ni unripe ni. Sayang eh. Berapa banyak kau sehari banyak ni sehari?
Berbelatan jugalah kita potong.
Berbelatan dan reject.
11 lah.
Ambil sini, ambil sini, ambil sini sikit. Sini sikit, ambil sini sikit. Sini sikit, ambil sini sikit.
Okey,
cukup dah cukup. Okey, so ini adalah tandan eh. Oh, tandan. Inilah tandan dalam tu.